Now let us see what is meant by homologous, analogous organs and also vestigial convergent evolutions. If you see these are all nothing but they are also the evidences of evolution. See, the direct evidence of evolution is scientists have observed examples of natural selection leading to the adaptive evolution such as bacterial resistance. So what scientists have observed is natural selection is leading into the adaptive evolution. The natural selection, natural selection is leading into the adaptive evolution. What is the meaning of this particular sequence? Here, whatever the nature is selecting, the nature selects those organisms which it has to be, which that particular organism has to sustain or it has to acclimatize or adjust to that particular environment. Such organisms will only live. So this is the natural selection, and whatever organisms are acclimatized to that environment only, they are giving rise to the new characters or new genes, and hence this type of mechanism or evolution, we call it as adaptive radiation. So this is the direct evidence of the evolution. Now what are fossils, and why this paleontology study is needed for the evolution of the life? The fossils are the remains or the traces of the organisms which provide evidence about the history of life on the earth. So what was the life, how was the life in the previous ages, and how they are connected to the modern age? Fossils show the evolutionary changes and the patterns that have occurred over the time in between and various groups of organisms. So these are the fossils, and the fossil records will show a very good particular evidence for the organic evolution to occur. Next is the homology. What is meant by homology? Homology means the organisms which have similar structures. That means if you take the from the ages till today, what are meant by appendages? Appendages are nothing but they are helping the organisms for the movement, that is locomotion. We want to move from this place to that place. So what are the organs which are helping for the movement? Our legs and hands. So in the same way, if you consider the lowermost organisms, the protozoans or the different types of cnidarians, they have the flagella, cilia, is it not, and tentacles for the movement. As this evolution has been slowly and steadily transformed, later on when you come to the phylum Annelida, Arthropoda, you can see the different types of small legs have been emerged, and thus they helped in the movement. When you come to the fishes or the water animals, fins are present, is it not? So in the same way for reptiles, again you can see small forelimbs and hind limbs, and when you come to the case of mammals, these are highly enlarged. So these are nothing but if you say they have similar structure, such structures we call it as homologous organs. And similarities among different organisms, characteristics anatomic and or molecular may be present in an ancestral organisms are passed down to the descendants, that is from one generation to the another generation. Now, what are vestigial structures? How are the vestigial structures are showing the evidence in evolution? If you see, what are these actually? They are the remnants of the structures once used by the extinct organisms which are found in the extant organisms. So, extant means that are living today. Extinct means they have been perished away. So vestigial organs are playing a very important role in the process of organic evolution. If you see these days, or there will be some genetic traits also, and we see that a baby born with a small tail, A small baby born with a small tail. From where we are getting this tail? Tail is not the character of the man, is it not? It is the character of mammals. Or in clear, we can say that this is the character of the lower organisms, is it not? But that has come to, and recently also we have seen this news also in the media. So why, what is this? That means once which trait was present in our ancestors, that has been seen in the present generation. So this is called as nothing but the vestigial structures. So they are proving that yes, we are there and we are providing the evidence for the organic evolution. So vestigial structures are very important for the process of the evidence of organic evolution. Next is convergent evolution. What is meant by convergent evolution? In the name only it is very clear. It is the similar features in different lineages. Analogous structures have similar function but different origin. That means here convergent evolution, they have the similar function but different origin. Origin is different. Example, you can take again the flying adaptations of birds and also the insects. So what is the function of bird's wing or a insect wing? It is nothing but flying. Flight adaptation. Their origin is different, but the functions are the same. So such type of evolution, which we call it as convergent evolution, is playing a very important role in the evidences of evolution. Okay, so the biogeography. What is biogeography? It is nothing but the geographic distribution of species that is based on the continental drifts. So what is this? The distribution of species on the earth. If you take the very best example is kangaroo. So you can see that these kangaroos are only situated in the Australian region. It is a island continent, is it not? So that particular environment, the kangaroos have been acclimatized and they are not able to come out to another environment of the earth where they are not acclimatized. And you can see also the different lung fishes like Protopterus, Neoceratodus. Okay, near all these lung fishes are also, they are confined to only one particular place on the earth. So we say such type of distribution as the biogeographical distribution. All these things are playing a very vital role in the process of organic evolution.